Thee Stallion. Should we mention that one? Yeah, a little update on that one. Yeah, yeah. Why not? Let's update on Megan Thee Stallion because, you know, I think I've mentioned that a few times on here, and I think it's only fair that I kind of round up that bit of news. But a story, it's an odd one, isn't it? This Megan Thee Stallion thing, because it keeps changing, it keeps morphing into other things. And I guess at the heart of it, really, a young lady was involved in a very violent altercation, it seems like, for the most part. And she got hurt. There's no way we can doubt that's not true. And it shouldn't happen, right? It just shouldn't happen. A young lady shouldn't be, no one should be pulling a gun out on a young woman whatsoever, especially during some sort of heated argument. You should be having an argument with a person and you should be maybe going on your separate ways, but there should be no occasions where pulling a gun out on a woman makes sense, unless they're obviously trying to kill you, right? You're involved in some kind of frenzied attack and they're about to pull a knife out on your throat and, you know, you have to defend yourself in any way, shape, or form you can. So we all agree it shouldn't have happened. Megan Thee Stallion shouldn't have been shot in any way, shape, or form. But I guess the issue at hand is that the details of the story sound a bit flaky, and the accusation that she put out there that she got shot in 2 feet with bullets just doesn't add up if you look at all the evidence that's gone out there. And it's a bit annoying because I think it's quite clear to me so far from the evidence that we got out there and from what we've heard via the LA Times and other sources that she didn't get shot directly in the foot. She might have been hit with fragments, with shrapnel, from a bullet that hit something else, but she wasn't shot directly in both feet as she claimed in the video. She was maybe hit in one foot that was obviously bleeding, hence the video we saw of her kind of limping out of the car when the police stopped the car that Tori and her were driving. But she wasn't shot directly in both feet, and it's annoying because I think the actual story is still bad. Even if Tori got so irate with her that he shot to the ground and it ricocheted and hit her foot, it doesn't matter. It's still unacceptable. You shouldn't be doing that to a woman. His career would have still been cancelled. He still would have a lot to answer for himself for. And if he didn't, his career would be cancelled regardless anyway. And, you know, we should try our best to protect all women in those situations, for sure. But to lie about it and to purposely embellish the story or to purposely leave out certain segments of it makes me think of the original issue that Megan kind of came into limelight with, was the story concerning her original record label, right? Where she sort of painted the story that she was being held at gunpoint or that she signed a contract under false pretenses. And then when the contract details were leaked to the media or leaked to the public, we then saw that the contract was just a standard 360 shitty deal that every musician gets when they first enter the scene or enter the industry. But because Megan Thee Stallion is one of the rare artists within the hip hop that comes in, because it happens to a few people, you get bestowed as the next one. There's certain people that have that kind of blessing. Cardi B had it when she first came in, right? As a new artist, she's kind of got the blessing and the benefit and the looks that kind of gives you the impression that she's kind of been positioned to be the next one coming up. So of course, with that, you see the money coming into your account, or you see the opportunity of deals that are coming in, and you see the cut that your label's taking, and it starts to really, you know, shake you at your core. It starts to fuck, you know, it doesn't sit right with your spirit, as they say on Black Twitter. So I'm sure that's what happened. She probably saw it and said, oh, hold on, my contract all fucked up. And then in an effort to kind of get out of her deal, she decided to make up the story about her being signed under false pretenses, make it seem as if her original record label had basically scammed her in some way, shape or form, when that wasn't the case. She just got a shitty deal like everyone else does. And then that case is still wrangling on. We don't really know if it actually got concluded. It may have got concluded, but that kind of really made me think, okay, she's doing this, you know, that's something you've done on purpose. You've obviously, you know what the truth is, but you want to paint it one way to get out your deal. Fair. But then to do this to Tory isn't fair, because I think the actual story is bad enough as it is, right? He still did something with the gun that made your feet bleed, but he didn't shoot you directly in the foot, because it's impossible for you to be shot in both feet and to be hanging around in bars and clubs. Everyone knows the foot's got the most bones in your body. For it to pass through both feet without touching any bones or any kind of, you know, tendons is crazy. For it to pass through one, maybe, but both is just insane. Then Megan obviously felt the pressure online with people kind of calling scorn on her story, calling her a liar, which I think is a bit of a stretch. I think she might have maybe embellished the truth because she's a bit angry at the person that she was involved in romantically with. People can get a bit, you know, bitter and all that sort of stuff. I'm sure that's what happened. I'm sure she's not a pathological liar, but she felt the pressure. She released a picture of her foot injury, then deleted it. But from the foot injury picture that we saw, and based on some of the information that we got online, it does kind of marry up to the story that it probably was shrapnel. And based on the story that has now been leaked from the LA Times or reported from the LA Times, we're now getting word that they're not investigating it as a shooting in general anyway. So let's read the article. It says here, Megan Thee Stallion had a gunshot wound needing surgery after Tory Lanez shot her. She says after Tory shot her. So this is from August the 22nd. It says the following. Megan Thee Stallion underwent surgery for a gunshot wound and shrapnel was removed from her left heel in the hours after she said she was shot in Hollywood Hills last month. More details of the incident emerged Friday, a day after the Stallion, for the first time through her Instagram live account, said that her fellow hip-hop star pulled the trigger that left her wounded on July the 12th, sorry. Which is interesting to me because she's finally named him. And I've always argued that I don't think black people get cancelled. We just don't. I think it took decades for R. Kelly to go into prison. It took years. It took even more for Bill Cosby to finally get brought to justice, even though everybody in the scene and knew what he was doing, if you believe what you read online. So I think Tory Lanez could probably, you know, could probably bounce back from this. Unfortunately so, or fortunately so, depending on where you sit with the cancel culture conversation. An even recent example is a Chris Brown issue. Usually back in the day, if you hit a woman, especially in Hollywood, if you weren't black, your career is completely over with. The fact that he was able to kind of bounce back from that says a lot about the industry too. I just don't think people are going to cancel him to an extent that people are thinking he's going to cancel to, in my opinion, even though he's been named by Megan. Medical records now in possession of authorities show that the rapper, who was born Megan Pete, underwent surgical procedure to remove a thrown object from her heel after she was shooting. She had a 4 centimeter wound, she recorded. A thrown object isn't a bullet. If it's a bullet, then say it's a bullet. So that's the first issue. The WAP and Savage rapper was treated at the Cedars-Sinai Medical Center. She reported she felt pain in both feet, though. With the Los Angeles County District Attorney Office considering whether to file felony assault charges with a firearm against Lane, Stallion said it was time for him to admit to shooting her. She said, as I quote, "Yes, Tory shot me, you got your publicists and your people to go around these blogs lying. Stop lying. Why lie? I don't understand." That's not true. I don't think Tory's doing that. I don't think it's within his interest to get his publicists to try and clear his name via the blogs. If anything, you want to clear your name in a court of law. The blogs are the worst places to go and defend yourself, especially most of the blogs are heavily female leaning, female favored, or, you know, in terms of the arguments that they get involved in terms of how they cover, you know, domestic disputes, they tend to usually favor the woman in the argument. So it's the worst place for him to defend himself. If anything, I think the commentators and the other independent meme pages and bloggers, such as the one I follow, like Mob Radio, she does some really good work. They've already been questioning the story from the onset because I think some of them already have a bit of an issue with Megan to begin with, don't get me wrong. But I think as the story's panned out and how it was kind of being reported, it just didn't seem like what she said happened. So I think the commentators were the ones that kind of led the scrutiny behind the story, because I think anybody else that got involved in this who probably was maybe more university liked, they wouldn't probably had such skepticism put against their story. Probably would have just believed it and moved on. It continues here. It says she acknowledged that when police first responded to the report of a shooting and found the two recording artists outside the SUV, she did not tell the responding officer she had been shot because she was afraid the legal repercussions and afraid for her safety, which is odd because you'd imagine if you're a police officer, you could probably ascertain what a bullet wound is. Again, you're not a doctor, I understand that, or a medical professional, but you've probably got enough experience on the streets to know what a bullet wound looked like if you're an officer, innit? But it continues, it says, "I didn't tell the police nothing because I didn't want us to get in trouble," she said in a video. She also said that she wanted to spare Lanez of trouble and did not explain how she was injured. Initially, she told officials that she thought that she was glass cut and not realize the nature of the wound. She was barefoot at the time of the incident after a night of partying. Lanez was arrested on suspicion of possession of a concealed weapon after the vehicle was he was stopped at LAPD. The video from the scene showed Lanez and Stallion limping barefoot. Lanez's real name was Daystar Peterson, was released on bail. LA County prosecutors on July 24th received a felony assault with firearm investigation from LAPD, but sent it back for further investigation. The 28-year-old rapper was not made any statements about the incident, but Stallion and her comments said she believed these publicists and people had been lying about the incident to deflect blame. Stallion, her friend, Lanez, and security guard with an SUV after the party. At a house owned by Kylie Jenner in early hours of July 12th, when the female rapper from Houston said the argument erupted and she decided she had enough to go out and walk away. She said she was minutes from the house she was staying in. She then alleged that as she was walking away, a fellow artist fired at her from the back seat. "You shot me. I didn't cut my glass, but I can tell you why they're saying that." It's funny they finally mentioned Kylie Jenner's name. They haven't mentioned it at all in the arguments, because I think the original story we heard from Adam 22 was supposedly Kylie and Tory were hitting it off or something along those lines. Megan saw that, got annoyed, they got into an argument. Kylie then asked them to leave her home because, you know, they're causing a scene, and then the argument spilled out into the SUV, hence the shooting. But we don't know if that's part of it's true, and if it is true, she's, you know, cooperating with this. She played some role in this, but when you're at that level of fame and that level of net worth, you just don't get involved in some sort of, some things you just don't get involved in, and it is what it is. On the night of July, LA officers swarmed the 180 block of the Nicholas Canyon about 4:30 a.m. after receiving a report of gunfire. According to LAPD, the witnesses of the incident provided a description of the suspect and their vehicle. Officers stopped the vehicle matching the description, detained mutual people, and eventually arrested Lanes, according to a statement. In a video of the aftermath, both Lanes and Stallion can be seen in handcuffs as officers try to determine what happened. Without naming the female rapper, LAPD said one person was taken to hospital with a foot injury. Again, nothing about bullet wound. Stallion, in the aftermath, repeatedly said that she had expected a full recovery, but said in the subsequent post about that the shooting and the subsequent surgery was super scary and the worst experience of her life. She felt blessed that the gunfire hit where it did. On Wednesday, Stallion posted and then deleted an image on Instagram that said she'd shown a result of being shot. "Why would I lie about being shot?" Stallion said in a blunt post in response to the comment she said she underwent. She had until Thursday avoided naming Lanes as a assailant, even in the interviews, but then she accused him of lying to cover up an episode, accused him of getting aliases on social media to drag her down. Okay, maybe that's true. I'm not too sure if that is, but I would think, in my opinion, if I was involved in some kind of domestic dispute with a female, the worst place I'd go and try and defend myself is a shade room comments. Like, you know, it's just not the place for men to try and fight their corner in that regard. I just think people have questions, man. I don't think the story matches up. I don't think the story makes sense. More so because of what she said. If Megan wasn't so quick to come out and say what happened, I think people would have just like let the story get dealt with in the courts and whatever information we got fed via the press we got fed. But because she's on social media reading comments, getting agitated by people kind of calling her a liar, she wants to respond and kind of fight back, and she does come across a little bit too angry, a little bit too hot-headed, a little bit too she just comes just a bit too angry. Like, you know, why would I lie? It's like, everybody lies. People lie all the time about nonsense things. There's you know, we don't know why you'd lie. You are you, we are us. So the lie can happen, we don't know. Again, she said she got shot in both feet. So far the evidence proves that she didn't get shot in both feet, maybe one. And no one's saying anything about a bullet, they're talking about a foreign object landed in her foot. And for me, I just don't know why she'd need to lie. Like, the story already is bad enough. Even if it is shrapnel, Tory Lane's career should be cancelled. He should be on hold. He should be, you know, in rehab, whatever. Immediately his deals are going to be, you know, completely wiped off the table, probably as they have done already. But I think for the most part, people are probably waiting until the actual verdict from the courts. But the story is bad enough as it is. No need to actually embellish it even more. But again, you know, I don't know what happens with people in Hollywood. Maybe, again, there's love involved. You get a bit angry. I'm not sure in the situation, but I'd love to hear the actual story. I'd love to hear what Kylie Jenner's role played in it in regards to it. And maybe we'll hear Tory Lanez's side of things later on as well. We never know. But yeah, let me know in the comments. What do you think? Do you think she's lying? Do you think she's telling the truth? Does it matter if she's lying? Is Tory Lanez's career over or not? Let me know down below.